so hot this year. There's a little color there.
I see.
Hari, what is it? Come, come.
Maybe we can talk while you're while you're doing it. Carry on, no problem.
Yeah. No, I want to take that color there.
Okay. So Nicholas, what does it take to win a award for 5 years in a row?
A lot of hard work, lot of dedication. It's really a job you got to do around the year. It cannot be done, say a month ahead of the event. Or 2 months ahead even, or right. 6 months even.
Right.
It's got to be planned right from winning the prize this year for the next year's event. And also considering our climatic conditions which are changing, the task is becoming even more and more difficult.
Yeah, it's tough. Could you introduce us to your garden and you know, what are the kind of specialties?
Well, I like to grow local flowers, Goan flowers.
Yeah.
Now this is one variety which does extremely well. It's called Crossandra in English, but it's our famous Aboni, which again Mogri Aboni. This is spoken of in, you know, folklore, you know, in our Mandos, in our Dulfod. So Chunti, Mogri, Aboni, these are local flowers,
right.
And they are the least troublesome to grow in Goa, right? Especially considering the temperatures now are going up, global warming, and so many other things. So I grow these, look at the mass effect, you know, it gives a lot of effect. Inputs are sort of minimum, not minimum you might say, but there is less inputs than for the specialized, you know, temperate climate plants, which I also grow.
Yeah, so what's your range of plants that you have?
I grow dahlias, chrysanthemums, roses, gerberas, ixoras, then dahlias, which I specialize in, anthuriums, which can be grown easily in Goa. They are nice to grow. And I grow Crossandra, then I grow Margaritas, I grow a lot of Crotons, Bougainvillea, which I like to grow. Again, a local plant suitable for our climate. Then Cannas, which are, you know, easy to grow. So I think people should try to grow the things which are, you know, suitable for their type of garden. Shade-loving plants. There are lots of shade. I also grow Begonias.
Yeah,
because they are also not difficult to grow. They are relatively easy to grow. So then I grow fruit trees, a lot of fruit trees, bananas, mangoes. And I do my own grafting, my own material. Because if you go to the market, sometimes you may not get the variety they are offering you. They say it's this and that. You know, and when you grow 10 years down the line, it turns out to be something else.
How many hours of work and how many years of work?
Years, since I was, say, 8 or 10 years old,
you're
looking at a loving hobby for last 50 years at least.
I see.
50 more than 50.
But this garden?
Huh?
This garden in particular?
Not this garden.
Yeah, I
was even growing abroad when I was living abroad. I was growing in the balcony on, you know, on the third, fourth floors.
I see.
So a lot of, I used to bring plant material from Europe, grow specialized chrysanthemums and dahlias and all there.
But this garden may be about 10 years or
this
more.
Is now at least 10 years.
10 years old.
And
how many hours every day?
On an average, because of the watering, because I do it myself,
I
don't hire labor to water the garden.
Yeah.
So you would say on an average 2 hours a day or 2.5 hours a day, on an average.
Yes.
But when planting time comes or season, beginning of season comes, then you're looking at 3-4 hours sometimes.
And you would advise or recommend this as a hobby to anyone interested?
I would particularly advise it to people who are retiring or who have retired and who want to keep in good health, you know. This is a health-giving hobby.
Yeah.
So you get the satisfaction of growing something, seeing a lot of color in your garden, seeing the green, greenery. And I tell you, it's the best way to burn up calories and best way to keep your mind, you know, at peace.
So it
gives you a lot of mental satisfaction as well and diverts your mind. And if you are a stressed person and full of stress, and this is the ideal hobby.
And a little on the fruit plants, the bananas,
yeah,
people
bananas,
talk about them a lot.
I grow about 6-8 varieties of bananas. from the dwarf Cavendish to the Moira bananas.
Yeah.
In between there are the Goa stop variety like the butter plantain, Rospali as we call in Konkani, which is a good variety to grow. I grow elchi, both the commercial elchi as well as our local field you the odd.
I see.
Yeah. So both the varieties.
Could it be commercially viable as a profession if someone wants to earn from it?
If someone had the place, like a, you got to grow it in the field. Or a big farm, you know, and it is commercially viable, provided you can undercrop it with other things.
I see.
It needs undercropping, you know,
see.
Then you can grow other things below.
I see.
But it cannot be grown in the middle of coconut trees or middle of mango trees. Bananas and especially bananas cannot be grown like that. They need an open space, they need a lot of air, and the roots, encroaching roots of big trees would deprive them of growing to their full potential.
I
mean, you're looking at commercial.
That's true.
Yeah, if you're growing on a commercial basis, I would recommend that you have to have a dedicated place. Now, Goa is having flower farms. There are flower farms in Goa, like Jaipara Farms. They are doing reasonably well, and there are companies who are willing to give you a lot of input, a lot of ideas, send people. They give you, first of all the technical details in advance. I would say that if a person is not doing anything, doesn't have a regular job, and if he has a place of his own, I mean, it's expensive to buy land.
Right.
But if you have a place of your own, say a big field which you're not tilling, and you're not growing the regular paddy crop,
which is
one crop you grow in Goa, then diversifying into this would be an ideal way. Growing papayas, bananas, fruits, which can be, you know, harvested easily enough, would be the right thing to do for people, younger people. I'm past the age where I would want to go in for a farm because of the labor problem. But younger people who've got the time to devote and their own energies, you know, to devote to this, it would be ideal.
Thanks so much, and all the best after winning the prize 5 years in a row.
Thank you. From A. Kumar Florist, who are in collaboration with the Dutch company.
I see. From where, Bangalore?
No, from Pune.
I see.
They grow 10 to 15 million plants at any given time and export to the world. Jaiparas, Milium.
I see.
These are the two, and Anthuriums. And they're reasonably priced, and you'd be surprised at the quality of these plants. And they're grown from tissue culture.
I see.
You get very pure, you know, virus-free and other trouble-free varieties.
I see.
So these are from Holland. From Holland, actually. They must be, you know, cultivating them, but they are grown here in Pune, under glass.
I see.
I got this double colored bougainvillea. Looks amazing.
I see
white and pink. And these are the ones which I have grown traditionally. These are good for the cut flower market, actually.
Anthuriums.
These.
If somebody
could grow these, you know, the price of each flower is about 25 to 30 rupees. Now, it is not a big deal to grow them, if you know how. And imagine a farm having 10,000 plants.
On the vegetables that...
I would really recommend to people in Goa
that
we depend so much on trucks coming from Belgaum. If one day the truck doesn't come, we don't have vegetables.
Right.
Now, we don't know what they're spraying on these plants, because... Personally, I've stopped eating lettuce and other leafy vegetables from the market because they got a residue of pesticides on them. I would recommend that if people have a place, and you know, especially in the rains where you don't have to water the thing, that you could grow a lot of vegetables. I crop and I eat my own grown vegetables, homegrown, for at least 4 months in a year, 5 months in a year.
I see.
So I grow lady fingers. I grow. Brinjal, eggplant, I grow tenli, I grow virvil, and other, you know, things which can be grown easily. I have a little bit of outside rats coming in, so I can't grow sweet corn or corn, because they tend to destroy the actual crop.